This is a high-speed remote control car. And in this video, I'm gonna modify every aspect of this car, including a secret wheel design, all in an attempt to break the world record. Also, this video is sponsored by War Thunder.
I've received this roller from Raz, and this thing looks amazing. All these parts are beautifully machined, and of course it's got all of his perfect pass parts already installed. So I've got this new motor from Hobbywing, and then I've also got this brand new Max 5 ESC from them. I've also got this massive motor from Hobbywing, so we're going to be able to upgrade if we need to.
It turns out one of the hardest things for this project was finding a suitable road to drive the car on. I literally scoured Google Earth for hours at a time trying to find the perfect spot.
I found this place and we come out here now. And essentially what it is, it's an old airfield which was built I think about 60 years ago and isn't really used much anymore at all. It's very long, it's 1.2 kilometers long, it's dead straight. My only concern with it is that the surface of the tar is quite rough. So as you can probably see here, it's quite coarse, so I'm a bit concerned that this is gonna really shred up those little foam tires.
Okay, we've got GPS, all our clips are in.
That thing moves. I can see why people like this. That was so much fun. Now I am extra excited to make it go even faster.
This was my first time ever speed running a car, and we got the car up to about 240 kilometers an hour or 150 miles per hour, which I was really happy with. It gave me a really good feel of how to drive the car at high speeds, and luckily this thing was on rails, yes, driving dead straight. Unfortunately, with the cover on, the FPV camera was not very useful. I also tried driving with the cover off, and it was actually pretty cool. The FPV view was obviously really clear. At the same time though, it felt like the camera was just way too close to the road, so I needed to lift it a lot higher. And you're gonna see how cool that looks later in this video. Now that I knew that the car was capable of reaching some decent speeds, it was time to 3D model the original cover. And I used these photos and dimensions given to me kindly by Raz from Perfect Pass, and I modeled the entire car as accurately as possible. After finishing the design, I uploaded it to AirShaper, which is a cloud-based virtual wind tunnel CFD software. So over here we've got the 3D pressure clouds, and this is basically where all the air is detaching from the car body. And you really want to avoid all of this because this just creates drag and slows the car down. Then we've got surface pressure, which is where you got high pressure and low pressure on the car. Obviously you want low pressure under the car as well to get more downforce. And then this is really fun because you can play with the vertical and horizontal streamlines of how the air follows the car body. And it's quite fun to see how the air interacts with the car. And all of this is really valuable insights when you're designing and optimizing a car body. And here you can see why you really want to cover up your wheels, because when they're spinning fast, they generate a lot of noise, a lot of drag. They just do not help the situation. Most importantly, we've got the forces. So this is the overall drag and this is our downforce. After this was probably the most time-consuming part of this whole project, which was designing and optimizing the shell to go around the car. And the goal with this is essentially just to reduce drag as much as possible while also maintaining a decent level of downforce. I think in total I did close to 100 simulations, and I'm going to show you my evolution of design now. This is the final design I settled on, and I'm actually really happy with how it turned out. And if you look at it from above, you can see I've actually developed this tapered design where the air is kind of pulled together towards the middle at the back of the car. And what that means is if we had parallel sides instead, there would be a much larger footprint at the back here, which would create a bigger drag profile. And what does all this mean? Well, at the end of the day, we're trying to reduce our drag force. And if you look at this number here, you can see that's exactly what we've done. Compared to the original car, of 12 newtons of drag. We have brought that all the way down to 7. Now, of course, this is all theoretical, so you're only going to be able to tell in real life when testing how much of a difference it'll make. But mathematically, this car should be a lot quicker. Next came the not so simple process of bringing this design to life. I decided to 3D print it in 8 separate pieces using bamboo's toughest and most heat resistant filament, PPACF.
The front 2 pieces are finished now, so it's time to see how they look, and that actually looks awesome. These are definitely the biggest prints I've ever done. So after about 100 hours of 3D printing, the mold is all finished and pushed together. You can see roughly what it's going to look like when it's in the car there for size reference.
The next step was to sand on all the ridges on the print and then also cover it in a resin and re-sand it again before it was ready for vacuum forming.
I'm at a manufacturing facility in Cape Town and we're actually going to vacuum form the mold now, so hopefully it all goes to plan. I'm just really hoping the mold doesn't break when they suck all the air out of it.
After heating up the acrylic sheet to about 190 degrees Celsius or 370 degrees Fahrenheit, they bring it over the mold, pull it down, and then suck all the air out so that it wraps itself around the mold. As you can see here, unfortunately the mold failed during the vacuum forming process. And I think it's because I made the walls of the print just too thin because I was trying to save filament. But anyways, at this point I had run out of filament, so I needed to find another option.
To get rid of some of my frustrations during all the failures in this project, I let off some steam by playing War Thunder. It's the most comprehensive vehicle combat game ever made, and it's available for free on PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and even mobile. It lets you command over 2,500 tanks, planes, ships, and helicopters across 10 major nations from the 1920s to modern day. The vehicles are incredibly detailed and with authentic sound effects, it really makes you feel like you're in the heart of the action. What I'm most excited for is the new mobile version for iOS and Android. Now you can play on the go with intuitive controls, impressive graphics, and the same massive multiplayer warfare. If you want to try it completely for free, you can click the link in the pinned comment or the video description and see why 70 million other people chose to play this epic game. If you are a new player or returning after 6 months on PC or console, you can claim a massive bonus pack for a limited time. You can see on screen now what this will include. Now let's get back to building the world's fastest remote control car.
So I've come to the CNC factory. I'm not sure how much of this you can actually hear, but in the back over there, you can see they're busy carving out the mold for the car, and it's really exciting. So cool to see something you've designed come to life.
After the CNC mold from MDF wood was completed, I needed to do the same process of covering it in resin and then sanding it and polishing it down before vacuum forming. This left me with a beautifully smooth mold, and I basically knew for sure that this one would work. We drilled holes in the mold to make sure that the center portion would also have a strong enough vacuum to pull the plastic over it. Once the sheet had heated up enough, it was ready to pull it over the mold.
Looks perfect.
And fortunately, we finally had a usable mold for this car.
I was running with the iFlight full send batteries. They're normally for drones, but they actually work really well for this as well. But now I have upgraded to the SMC drag run series, and these batteries are phenomenal. They deliver tons of current with the lowest voltage sag I have seen. And I'm also running with the ISDT K4 charger. This is a super nice 8S capable charger, so if you're looking to upgrade, I would definitely consider it. It's really starting to come together now, looking very good. And what I'm gonna do now is cut the hole here for the fin to go on top. Back at the runway, ready for some more speed runs. And we're gonna do the standard FC100 cover first. and then I'm gonna make some adjustments to the car, and then we're gonna switch over to my new cover.
Unfortunately, there was a problem with the motor and the ESC that I couldn't quite figure out, so the speed was limited to about 100 kilometers an hour or 60 miles per hour. But on the bright side, I got to test out my raised FPV camera, and this view is amazing. It makes it so much easier to drive the car. Also, there wasn't enough clearance in the front, so the cover got shredded, so maybe it was a good thing it wasn't going too fast. While I got a new cover made, I decided to work on my brand new wheel design. So when you're designing something like a wheel, you're going to go through a lot of different prototypes, and this is a bit of an evolution of my design process. And you can see I've even printed these stencils to get the exact right sizing of these pieces on the hub. And I was finally left with this design, which is incredibly strong and fits perfectly on the wheel. My workshop isn't quite equipped to do this, but luckily my friend Ben has an awesome workshop and helped me finish off these wheels. Oh yeah. The foam wheels are finished and they're looking really good. You can see there's a nice smooth finish on them, and I think these could be really solid, so I'm very excited to test these out on the road. And we also made these wheels, which is the exact same hub, but we've glued on this hard rubber. So in theory, this will be way more durable, but at the same time, it's also a lot heavier. So with the high G forces, this rubber could literally rip off the wheel. And I've also got the BSR orange and the BSR purple. So we're gonna put all four of these wheels on the bench tester here, and we're gonna spin them up to some really high RPM. The bench tests were very interesting. The BSR orange could go up to about 20,000 RPM before the foam started expanding way too much. The BSR purples have basically no foam expansion, but at about 21,000 RPM and higher, the wheel starts coning out really badly. Unfortunately, every foam wheel me and Ben made failed below 17,000 RPM, so we clearly need to figure out a way of gluing the foam better to the wheel. The hard rubber glued to my custom wheel worked shockingly well, handling up to 26,000 RPM without any deformation. Unfortunately, it did pull so much current that the ESC exploded. I know a lot of you were really concerned in my previous video that I didn't have a fire extinguisher. But don't worry, I've gotten one now, so you can all rest assured that safety is my number one priority on this channel. Because my custom foam wheels failed, I decided it would be a good idea to go and test the hard rubber wheels, which seem to work really well. We've got the rubber wheels installed, and we're gonna test that out now, but not too confident about this, because just driving it around a little bit, it feels weird, I think it's slipping, but there's only one way to find out if this is actually going to work at all. So the wheel fell off at a blistering 80 kilometers an hour, which is not exactly what we wanted, but it's all part of the learning process. And in terms of these wheels, it's a bit uncertain because we couldn't test them properly, but by the amount of wear they have on them already, I don't think they would handle super high speeds. And in terms of what broke there, I'm not sure why that happened, but could have something to do with just an unlucky joint, or maybe because there's no foam giving suspension to these axles here. I don't know, but we're gonna have to figure this out and move on. While I changed out the CVD axle, me and Ben also built a steel splitter at the front just to give extra protection for the car.
We are back for some more test runs, and I've got a good feeling about this one. So on this setup, we've got both of these 70125 Hobbywing motors. So these guys are huge with the max 4 ESCs, and I'm gonna run one motor first, and then we're gonna switch to dual motor. Also, I've got that new splitter in the front installed, so that's gonna protect the cover nicely.
The first speedrun went okay, but I was getting some clear current limiting where the car would speed up and then slow down and then speed up and then slow down. So for the next run, I increased the time delay in the perfect pass launch control.
This thing picks up so much dust when it rides on this road. But anyways, clearly the one motor wasn't quite working well. So I've engaged the second motor. So we're gonna see what we can get with this setup now.
And this is when the car decided that it wanted to be a plane instead of a car.
And we are moving.
So the car is over here and the batteries are all the way over here. So I guess that's why you need battery straps. So I'm not really sure what the damage is yet, but it doesn't actually look that bad. I can see this wheel is scraped up there, so maybe that's what caused the failure.
So it turns out I did push the wheels too hard, and you can actually see the foam coming off them just before it crashed. It's all just part of the learning process, but unfortunately we're gonna have to pick up from here in the next video.
To keep yourself entertained while you're waiting for part two of this video to come out, you can download War Thunder for free using my link in the description below. And if you do that, for a limited time, you'll also get a bunch of bonuses like 100,000 free Silver Lions and 7 days free premium account. And also it's available across many platforms such as PlayStation, Xbox, PC, and even mobile now. So whatever you have, you can play it. And don't forget to subscribe because that next video is gonna be epic. And I promise you, I am going to break that world record. If you want to see another video I did where I broke a Guinness World Record, I'll put it on screen now, and I'll see you in the next one.